Well, while the drama in Washington continues, Wall Street is blocking out the noise and staying squarely focused on the fundamentals. Earnings and global growth are all supporting stocks, which saw the Dow Jones Industrial Average close at a new high. The blue chip Dow Index advanced 33 points to 21,830. The Nasdaq lost 7 and the S&P 500 fell 3. For the week, the Dow was the big winner. Bob Pisani has more on what's driving the market.
The stock market has a high-class problem right now. An awful lot is going right. First and foremost, earnings have been strong. We're past the halfway mark. Earnings are up more than 10% year over year. Revenues are up 5%. Estimates are strong for the third quarter as well. Valuations are higher, all right, but the markets are comfortable as long as there is earnings growth and the economy is improving. And the global economy has been improving. Money is flowing into European stocks this year. The credit markets are in great shape. Defaults are low and a recession nowhere on the horizon. Next, the dollar's been dropping, providing a tailwind for exporters. And rates are low. And the Fed's reiterated this week that rates will stay low for a long time and nobody's expecting a rate hike until December. All right, what could go wrong with this? Yes, Washington's a mess. But the markets don't care as long as tax cuts are somewhere on the horizon, and 2018 has proven good enough so far. There's definitely some kind of premium in the market for a tax cut, but we don't know how big this premium is. Another issue that is sort of puzzling market watchers is geopolitical risk. Today, the North Koreans fired a missile into the Sea of Japan, but the markets shrugged it off. Janus's Bill Gross said earlier this week that a significant geopolitical event like North Korea would usually carry a higher risk premium, but so far, that hasn't been the case. For Nightly Business Report, I'm Bob Pisani at the New York Stock Exchange.